Number 4, fuels. Within that, we have completed definition, classification, then characteristics of good fuel, next calorific value, which is considered to be important part from the point of view of your exam. Calorific value, we have studied classification of calorific value as gross calorific value and low calorific value. Gross calorific value is nothing but amount of heat liberated by burning unit volume of fuel, and products are allowed to condense. In this case, we get more value of heat as expected, because after condensation, let us consider silica crucible. In this crucible, if we heat known weight of fuel, then if we condense the product, heat will be added, and ultimately we get additional amount of heat, that is called as gross calorific value or high calorific value. Secondly, low calorific value is amount of heat liberated by burning unit volume of fuel, and products are allowed to escape, so that ultimate heat obtained will be less than expected. If we heat same amount of fuel taken above in a silica container, and then it is combusted, after its complete combustion, products will be escaped, and we get ultimately low calorific value or net calorific value. These two calorific values can be calculated by using equation. GCV is equal to 1/100 1880 percentage of carbon plus 34,500 percentage of hydrogen minus percentage of oxygen divided by 8 plus 22,400 percentage of sulfur. While low calorific value is calculated by using relation, low calorific value is equal to gross calorific value or high calorific value minus 0.09 hydrogen percentage into 587 kilocalorie per kilogram or calorie per gram. Next we have studied determination of calorific value of solid or non-volatile liquid by using one calorimeter called as Bohm calorimeter. Secondly, we use